Welcome AGI Westfield customers to today's how-to video. How to change a hopper flight in an MKX 13-inch auger, low pro hopper. We start by removing the wire mesh, the safety mesh, and the sprocket and chain cover at the end, undoing the tensioner bracket so that you can loosen your chain. And then once you have the chain loosened off a bit, you can undo it so that you can access your sprocket on the flight shaft, undo your set screws, pull off the sprocket. Loosen off the bearing, the two bolt flangette bearing, undo the locking collar, removing the Woodruff key out of the stub shaft. Now he's unlocking the locking collar on the bearing and pulling it off. And then this end is free. Now we go to the other end where we have a bushing support, and we have to take that bushing support off just to give us a little more wiggle room. And there you go. The flight is out. New flight going in, and then we reverse. Put a little grease on the shaft so your bearing slides on smooth and easy. Reinstall the bearing with the two bolt flangette. Locking collar, but we're not going to lock it yet. Woodruff key back into place, and aligning the sprocket. So that's why we didn't do the locking collar before. We want to align the sprocket and make sure it's all flush. Once we have that locked up, set screws tightened, both on the locking collar of the bearing and also on the sprocket, reinstalling the bushing support at the other end, connecting the chain. Now we're going to tighten up the idler sprocket, and he's going to wiggle the chain just to check for tension so that we get the right tension. And then lock that slider bracket. Give it a grease job. Put your covers back on, safety shield here, the safety mesh in the hopper, and we're done. And that took us 3 minutes and a few seconds. It took him less than an hour to change a hopper flight. Thanks, guys.